So, yeah, we had güiro, bongos, clave, tres, maracas. Later on, they started adding trumpets. Yeah, so trumpet is a sun instrument right now as well, and more percussion. I mean, timbales mainly. In modern timba music, drum set is pretty, like full drum kit is pretty important instrument as well. Back in times, it didn't exist in son, not at all. I think like first one was Changuito that started, even not including the full drum kit, but like just a kick drum, and then step by step they were adding more and more. And now in the full Cuban orchestras like Havana de Primera, you have 18 musicians. That's crazy. And they started with six. And still in Cuba, you have fantastic arrangements with just, with just four musicians. Yeah, so this is pretty great. When I was saying about the six musicians, the arrangement is called septeto, and like the first ones were Septeto Nacional or Septeto Santiaguero. Again, a lot of songs available online. Again, we'll try to put some links so you can listen to some music, and we do encourage you to listen to some music
Yeah.
because it's beautiful.
And not only listen to music, go see live music as well. Because like it's like actually seeing the instruments being played actually makes it all kind of click. I know we were saying that basically we both went to see Buena Vista Social Club maybe about 5 years ago or something like that. Was it 4 or 5 years ago?
Which one was it? Like the one
In
in
Bridgewater
the oh, that
Hall.
was longer than
Is
that
it
was
longer? Yeah.
7 years
Yeah,
ago.
7 years ago. That was my first like appreciation of like Cuban music.
I've seen them a couple of times. They are the reason why Cuban music went out from the island, basically. Like, I don't want to call them commercial band. They are actually authentic Cuban band that managed to have influence on
Yeah.
European and American culture. So that's pretty great achievement
Yeah.
in
And I
general.
think it is most people's first interaction with Cuban music, like
Yeah, especially Chan Chan. Yeah, that's
yeah,
like
Chan Chan, Cuarto de Tula as
so
well.
characteristic song. The last thing we are going to talk are artists who had the biggest impact
He
on.
says we are going to talk, but he mainly means he is going
Yeah, no, I'll let you talk.
to
I'll let you talk
talk.
because I know that you are a big fan of sun music, and even like few days, what it was, day ago, 2 days ago, you sent me the new album of Eliades Ochoa. Yeah, so he's definitely up to date with sun music. So this is very important fact, actually. Sun music is still being developed. It's not like music from centuries ago. Yeah, Buena Vista Social Club was created in 1932, so quite long time ago. And yeah, like this Montuno pattern by Arsenio Rodriguez, that was like 1934 or something like that. So like pretty late times, and these patterns are still used. And like from original Buena Vista Social Club setup, not many people are still alive. There is Omar Aportuondo. Eliades Ochoa. I mean, he was probably not in original setup, but he played with them quite a lot. There is, by the way, very good documentary about Buena Vista Social Club. I think it's even called Buena Vista. Or have a look. It's part of history of Cuba and part of history of Cuban music. We highly recommend it. Yeah, and exactly like what the songs that we were talking about before: Chan Chan, Cuarto de Tula, Candela, but not like La Candela, like Los Van Van, but.
No, the other one.
And then doom 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 doom. This one.
I think one of the things which attracted me to Cuban music more and Cuban dance more than anything was the fact that every year there's great like music just on the cutting edge. It's not looking backwards. Like if you look at say swing dance or tango or something, both dances which I really like, but it's like kind of stuck in a time period, that kind of music, if you know what I mean. I know there's like more modern versions,
Oh
but Cuban music, like I'm so excited for every new release to come out because it's always inventive and always creative
it
and
is a cool thing, actually. I mean, when it comes to swing or tango, one of the elements of this culture is actually that people dress up the same as they used to dress up there. It's a bit more like whole culture coming together. In Cuban music, it's still evolving. It's very cool. And even when it comes to song, good example for that is Calle Real. They have just few songs, but one of them is Sukiyaki. That was I think I told you about this song. This is song based on Japanese traditional song. So there was tsunami in 2011, and they wanted to contribute somehow to help Japanese people, and they recorded the song. They covered Japanese traditional song into son. It's fantastic. I love it.
I need to listen to that again. If it's not on an album, is it? It's not on Spotify or anything.
I don't know if it's on Spotify or not, but it's on YouTube, definitely. Yeah, it's there. And another band, it doesn't have that much effect now on music, but it had at some point, Sierra Maestra. Mm. For me, it's fantastic band. They were creating soundtrack for movie Salsa. There is a movie called Salsa. I'm not sure which year it is, but it's available on YouTube as well. You can watch it in full. And they created whole music, and especially the song Es mi música, you don't know this song, maybe.
No.
So that was like a theme song, but the movie is hilarious. It's about a French guy who wants to become Cuban. So he darkens his face, he learns how to dance, and he's pianist actually as well. It's fantastic. I mean, it's ridiculous at the same time. Worth to watch it. The bands in general, I like now Calle Vapor, they have an album that they covered many, many big song hits like El Manicero. What do they have there? Son de la Loma. Lots of like big songs covered in very approachable way.
Mm.
Because there are some songs that are hard to listen, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Even this Aliades Ochoa song that played at the party, Estoy Como Nunca, there is like massive bass improvisation, so to dance to it, it's not obvious, but like say Calle Vapor, it's like for the first impression, it's very
I was listening to the version of Chan Chan the other day in the car, and it's good, it's very jazzy what they do with it, but they make it their own, definitely.
Yeah.
But the clavier player plays wrong.
Oh.
Yeah. He makes a mistake. In the second half of the song, it basically changes from the songs into the kind of like more of a salsa feel.
Mm.
And yeah, it's on the recording. Yeah, he continues playing 3-2 kind of clave, but it's clearly switched into a 2-3 from all the other instruments you can tell. So
okay.
Yeah.
So that's
Calle Vapor.
Yeah. We have an eye on it. I'll just tell you very quickly story about Sierra Maestra, because this was shocking experience for me. I have to talk about it. I know we've been talking already for quite a lot. Maybe it will be two episodes about someone. But Sierra Maestra came to Manchester twice. Once, actually not to Manchester itself, but to Clitheroe, that's north of Manchester.
Oh.
And they were playing in a town hall there, like a massive hall. People were just sitting and eating, and they were playing. We were the only couple dancing.
Oh.
That was shocking experience. Shocking. We still enjoyed ourselves.
Yeah.
But it was very, very strange to bring that big band.
Yeah.
Because, like I said, this is a band that made a soundtrack for quite a big movie.
Mm.
So they were quite popular. They're coming here, nobody knows about them. Mm. Second time, they played in Band on the Wall.
Mm.
And also, not many dancers there. Maybe like 10. And actually, some of them went for dinner after with them. I couldn't stay because I had some other duties. I regret it till today that I never went with them. Yeah.
What's your favorite Sierra Maestra song?
Yeah, I think I was still Dundumbanza.
Dundumbanza.
Yeah.
Mine's La Caminadora.
Yeah.
That's the first track on Rumbero Soy. And it's got, what I love about it is the end, it's got like a conga compasso kind of feel with all the bells and stuff.
Yeah.
But it's crazy. And it kind of like to me, it eliminates that misconception that son has to be slow.
Of course, son doesn't have to be slow. Son doesn't have to be old as well. Son is, in general, the musical concept. It can be followed in many, many ways. Like Havana de Primera is releasing and each album basically some son song. Yeah, like you can easily classify Mujeriego as son.
Yeah.
Like the previous. The previous album, what was Vuelta al Mundo? Yeah. There was Son as well. Or Venenosa, that was
Venenosa.
So, La Familia Valeria Miranda, that's also the band that plays very cool version of Son, like based on Tres. Like Tres in there, like there's so many amazing solos. Very, very cool thing to listen. We'll list all of this under the video.
I don't know what they called again.
La Familia Valeria Miranda. Abur Pisano, for example.
I don't recognise that, but it was an excellent rendition, I'm sure.
It's
just send it to me.
Yeah. I will. I'll put it under the video in the description. I think we plan to talk about Rumba as well, but it already dragged for
quite a while.
Yes, we'll talk about Rumba a bit more. But before we finish this episode, under the video you can click subscribe. You can click like. You can find us on other social media, Instagram, Facebook, and we'll do more weird materials for you if you like this one. Okay, that's it. Thank you.